You're welcome onto the program Tales of Odu. We know that Odu Ifá is a sacred text of the spiritual, ethical tradition of Ifá. And don't forget that Ifá has its origins in ancient Yoruba land. My name is Opeyemi Olumolade, and I have with me Dr. Oluwo Fatunde Fayemi Fakayode. You're welcome to the program again.
Yeah.
All right, today we'll be looking at temper and patience. What does Odu Ifá say about patience? What does it say about having a temper? We know that there are so many people that they'll say, it's my temper. I'm easily angered. And there are some people, you know, that they'll say it's patience, you need to kill this other person. Now, what does Ifá say about patience? What does it say about temper? Oluwo Dr. Fakayode is here to let us into this. Once again, welcome onto the program.
Good day.
So,
when we are talking about anger or temper, hot temper in Ifá, or we are talking about patience, the Odu that normally talks about that is Ogbe Ogunda.
Ogbe Ogunda.
Which can that also be called Ogbe Yonu.
Okay.
We call it Ogbe Ogunda, Ogbe Yonu, or Ogbe Suuru. This Odu tells us about anger and patience. And in the Odu, we can see which one is better. Let's say which one is good and which one is bad. Which one is beneficial or advantageous to people. If we look at the Odu, we can see that it is not only one verse from that Odu that talks about patience or anger. It's several verses from that Odu that talk about that. If we go into the Odu, we can just take a verse, for example, from Ogbe Ogunda. A verse says, Agoro nu oda nkan fun ni suru ni baba wa agba to ni suru gbogbo loni adiba mo orun mi la jo ti ba nsawo lo si ode wo. That is, anger is of no good to people. Patience is the virtue of everything. Whoever is endowed with patience has possessed all good things that one may think of in life. That was the Ifá declaration to Anumila when he was going to the city of Iwo. Ifá jawolo si ode wo yo fiya ti somo oluwo saya. And when he got to the city of Iwo, he married Iya, a daughter of the king of
Iwo. Iya, like something
like we can say suffering.
Suffering, okay.
Yes. On getting to when Anumila was going to the city of Iwo, he went for divination, and he was told that the city of Iwo that you are going, if you want to be successful there, and you want to profit over whatever you lay your hand over there, you have to be patient, and you should do away with any kind of hot temper or anger. On getting to the city of Iwo, Anumila was doing spiritual work, but later he came across a beautiful lady, and the name was Iya, daughter of Oluwo. Then Anumila was attracted by the beauty of the lady. Then he proposed to the lady, and the lady agreed. Then they went to the parents for introduction and other things. And when Anumila was dating her, she was the kind of person that would always want to frustrate the husband. But because of the message that Anumila received before he went to Iwo, he was always patient with her.
Yeah.
And when they finally got married, whenever Oromila went out, before he came back, he would just take maybe the iroke, the tapa of Oromila. The wife could use it to prepare food as firewood. At times, she would just use the ifa tray, the okun ifa of Oromila,
okay,
to make fire to prepare food. Or even the irukere, the oster. And when Oromila came back, after eating, when he heard of the ifa tree, okun ifa, I would just say, okay, you've taken your food. Where did you think I got the firewood that I used to cook the food? Did you expect me to use my fingers or my toes to cook the food? No, I use your ifa tray as firewood.
Wow. That's not like anybody angry.
Formula would just say, oh, but I have received message not to be angry. He had did many things like that to Oromila, and the day they wanted to leave the city of Iwo for Ile-Ife, as they were going, they saw any log of wood on the road. Instead of them to cross it, he would just say, I will not go again if you could not remove the tree or cut it. Oromila would just remove his cutlass
to cut the tree,
to cut the tree before they could pass. And on getting to Ile-Ife, everybody was happy that Oromila has arrived with a new wife. And they would just go there, Oromila, you are welcome. So you have brought another obirin or aya, which was the original name for wife in Yoruba land.
Aya.
Aya. You have brought another aya. Then Oromila would just tell them, though, that is a new aya, but that is the year that I passed through in Iwo.
So the suffering in Iwo.
The suffering in Iwo, Iya Iwo. And whenever anything happened, maybe between a husband and wife, and they went to Oromila for settlement to mediate, Oromila would just say, oh, you are fighting with your wife. That is your whole Iya Iwo as well. Then the suffering you have to endure, like the one I passed through in Iwo. That was how it now became the word for wife in Yoruba land. They changed from calling wife Aya to Iya Iwo.
Now there's another one you talked about, Biere.
Yes, and from Ogbe Ogunda as well. When you look at it, there is another verse that talks about Oka, Eri, Sebe, Nini. In the verse, if I says, Inu bibi ni so bi won ti wa jangbile yan ni bi ra re han oko se re de oruko ni so ni adifa fun oka adifa fun ere adifa fun sebi adifa fun nini ti so mo kan won lenje lenje. That is, anger can show us where somebody comes from, because at times it's hereditary. When you look at some people, you say this person has hot temper, and if you look at the person critically, if you know the history of the family, you will see that maybe that person, the father, is also stubborn, or the mother, or somebody in the family. There was a time, Oka, the viper.
So, what you're saying now is that temper goes hand in hand with one's character.
Yes. Oka, the viper, Eri, the royal boa constrictor, the Nini, is a non-poisonous snake and very beautiful. Yeah. There were four, and according to Ifa, they were from the same father. And Oka was a person with hot temper, and whoever offended Oka, even till now, if somebody, because Oka is a snake, if somebody should stay on the tail of Oka, Oka,
so
yeah, Oka will kill the person.
So
Oka will bite the person, and it's very, very poisonous. And Oka was somebody with Hot temper, the same thing with Sebe and the same thing with Boa Constrictor, Eri. Only Nini was somebody with good character. He would never be angry. They were just like that. And there was a time when the king of Apa died. Alapa Nirawele Nilio Ninyanja was their father, according to Ifá. And when he died, Oka was the firstborn. Then the kingmakers, they said Oka should be the next king. And hearing the news by the people of the community, everybody started going to the kingmakers that we would not agree to have Oka as our king, because Oka is wicked. He's somebody with hot temper. He has some people, just like nowadays, that people will just be writing petition. Oka has killed so person in so year, and they did the same thing for Sebe and for Boa Constrictor, that they have killed many people, they have injured many people, wounded many people, they've damaged many family and things like that. They could not make Oka, because of his character, they could not make him the king. The same way, thing with Sebe and with Boa Constrictor. Then, when there was nobody again to use, they said the only person now that can be made the king of Apa is Nene,
which is the youngest of them.
And that was how Nene was made the king of Apa. And they were saying, Oka lo siwa wu lo ba sireje la fi mu Nene joba, ere lo siwa wu lo ba sireje la mu Nene joba. That is, it is Oka that misbehaved. That was why Nene was made the king of Apa. It's not because Nene was the most qualified, but because of the character of the elder brothers. When we look at that, we see what hot temper can cause for a person. Because hot temper can destroy one's destiny.
Yeah.
Because if there is something like a fortune that the person wants to receive, hot temper can repel the fortune. Even for business people, businessmen or women, if you are hot-tempered, people will not patronize the person. Maybe because of the hot temper, you have insulted somebody because of maybe a simple something that it was supposed to be settled amicably.
And you cannot control your temper.
Person, you will not control your temper. The person will not patronize that person again. And it is when one is about to get fortune, something good, that people will remember what the person has done in the past. Because people don't normally forget things. They can forgive, but when they say we forgive, at times it will not be total forgiveness.
Yes.
When it is time for them to revenge, they will do. They will do. According to Ogbe Ogunda, it is not good to be hot tempered.
Obara Obodi.
That is another Odu. If we are going to Obara Odi, the main message in Obara Odi is all about, how do we, concentration and seriousness, and not to be roaming about unnecessarily. Because they will say, oh, Baro Godi, dear Mali, Kenkeli, Enini, Tani. That is, you should not be roaming about unnecessarily. If you have a shop, you should always be in your shop to attend to your customers, to sell your things. Not that you have a shop here selling a kind of a commodity, and when the person who wants to patronize you arrives, you are not in your shop. You are in the maybe third shop doing some maybe gossiping with another person.
It doesn't have to anything to do with patience.
Papa Robodi has nothing to do with patience directly.
Directly, but indirectly,
it has to do with patience, because it is when you are patient also that you always be in your house, be in your shop, be with your business, that you will not be going from one place to the other. That is, you know, some people, it's because maybe in their shop today, they don't, what they sell is not enough according to them. Tomorrow, you will not see them with that business again. They can change business as they like. some people they will have about 10, they will change to about 10 business within a year. That's what Obaru Budi is.
It's all about. How about Otua, Otua Ogbe?
Otura Ogbe is called Otura Orifa or Otura Orirere or Otura Orilana or Otura Oriko. Otura Orifa is talking about destiny. It has to do with patience. At the same time, he's talking about destiny, that one should be satisfied
with whatever
your
destiny has apportioned to
that
you.
Whatever happens to you should be seen as part of your destiny. You don't need to accuse anybody.
Okay.
You don't need to be angry with anybody because of your failure to achieve something. Don't say because your business is not booming that is so person that is causing the problem for you, that is so person that is disturbing you, is so person. Otura Ogbe is talking about destiny, about one's head, that when you are doing, when we gather businessmen now, we have like 100. What Otura Ogbe is telling us is that within the 100 businessmen that we have, one will be most successful. The others will follow. So part of them, some others will also be successful, but not as the degree of their success cannot be compared with the degree of the success of the single person, the head. And it's like in layers, in stages, levels, that you have one at the apex, some next, and you have some at the base, looking up to others. That is why Nobara and Mutura Ogbe, if I say, so Rumila, no, this is it. If I'm yasin, while you are ye, Olento, why you PNU, Simwa, and you're tossing one walk or PNU, Wawa, that is the person that are destined to be successful in life. They are, but those who are destined to be following them, they are not as many as the ones that are destined to be successful. And those who are even destined to be their servants, they are many. Their population is greater than the people that they serve.
But when you say that we should be satisfied with whatever destiny apportioned to us, I'm feeling that one should strive, because we don't actually know what exactly destiny has apportioned to each and every one of us. So one should strive to make it. So ti mo ba wo wi pe mo wa leyin o ye ki lo siwaju, so I should be able to strive, not minding the fact that okay, this is what destiny has apportioned to me.
Thank you. It is necessary to strive, to struggle. In Owari Otura,
okay,
Ifá says, Baba se pori gbogbo ni nsun po si iroko oba ti ku kan ninu oko Adifa fun gbe ni mo torun bo aye Adifa fun were ore torun bo aye o were la nja gbogbo wa eyan to yan rirere owo po o were la nja gbogbo wa. That is it. If it is everybody that will be buried with coffin, your local tree will have been exhausted.
Yes, in the forest.
In the forest. That is, it is not everybody that will be buried with coffin. Some are destined maybe to be carried away by a river.
Mm-hmm.
Some are destined to be burnt by fire to ashes, so that mm-hmm. they will not even see the corpse to bury. And that was the declaration of Ifá to men when they were coming to the planet Earth. And Owere. Owere means struggle. That is, everybody will have to struggle. The people that are destined to be successful without any kind of struggle, they are not as many, they are very few. That is why it is not bad for people to struggle. You have to strive. But once you struggle on something and you know you are unable to achieve it, it's not advisable to go extra mile. You have to struggle, because you cannot resign back to faith. Because the people will say to resign back to faith is madness. You can't resign back to faith and say it's my destiny to fail.
Yes, so I just sit back and relax.
Successful.
Oh, my, it's my destiny to be successful, hey. And I'll just relax.
If you say it's my destiny to be successful and you don't work towards it, the
failure is
yes, you have to struggle. But what if I is saying is, once you struggle over a particular thing, once you have done your own part, satisfactorily, you know, I have done my own part, you leave the others to Olodumare to do with prayer and labor and other things.
Okay. Yes, thank you so very much again today, Dr. Fakayode. We looked at different Odu, starting with Ogbe Onda. Okay. Like I used to say, that in Kometa, Onode Okunpa, Ode Paso, Ode Kofu, Ode Padanu, Ani Paso, Ani Kofu, Ani Padanu, Ogbara, Oni Shekun Shekun Fish, Ajelo Jojimo, Ajam Ajeto Alo Jojimo.
Ashe.
You know the tongue of war, man. Oju Ipon Shaila, Oju Omi Konwa. Until some other time where we meet again, I'd like to say a big thank you to Yomi Adigun and Michael Ajayi. My name is Opeyemi. Oh, my life is here.